600 new cleaning staff will be directly employed by the Scottish NHS to improve hospital hygiene. The announcement came from Health Secretary Nicola Sturgeon at the SNP Spring Conference in Glasgow. Here's our political editor, Brian Taylor.
There's alcohol gel outside every room, which can be used just to sort of cleanse your hands before coming into the room. There's also gloves and apron.
That's how it should work. But too often, patients pick up infections in hospital. Ministers say the rate of C. difficile is down by 20% in a year, but that's nowhere near good enough. And so more than 600 extra cleaners are to be recruited in Scotland's hospitals. Full or part-time, they'll all be employed directly by the NHS, not contractors.
The people of Scotland can rest assured that these will be cleaners working in the NHS, for the NHS and employed by the NHS. There will be no Labour privatisation of cleaning services by this SNP government.
Nicola Sturgeon also announced that she's doubling the fund for new council housing to £50 million. Both initiatives are also designed to boost jobs. Warm applause for all that, but the minority government has meant the shelving of key SNP policies, such as local income tax. In an interview, Alex Salmond hinted he might seek a future coalition, possibly with the Liberal Democrats.
Don't deny the possibility that minority government is not a bad option to have, but I'm equally not foreclosing on the possibility in a different parliament you might be looking for a different arrangement.
But for now, the SNP is keen to sustain popular support for their own party. With that in mind, a new campaign slogan: we've got what it takes.
Well, let's speak to Brian at the conference now. Brian, we couldn't miss the slogan there, which is presumably the point. What's the thinking behind it?
Yeah, you're right. You can see it behind me there in big scale. You can see it here as well in the campaign literature. It'll be going around. Get used to the slogan. You're going to hear it all the time. It's intriguing, isn't it? It's the saltire that's on it, not the SNP logo. I think it's double-edged. I think they're saying we, the SNP, have got what it takes to govern. I think more than that, they're saying that Scotland has still got what it takes to thrive and survive in these very difficult economic times. They're trying to counter the idea of a collapse of confidence in the economy in Scotland. That matters, but why does it matter particularly to the SNP? Because if there is a collapse of confidence in Scotland, if people don't feel confident about their own future, they probably don't feel confident about the prospect of independence, and therefore they don't feel confident about the party associated with independence, the SNP.
There was also, Brian, a sombre tone to part of today's proceedings.
There was, Sally. The conference opened later. There was a minute's silence for Bashir Ahmad, the late MSP, and also for Professor Sir Neil McCormick. Indeed, a memorial service for Sir Neil was held today. He's the former MEP and, of course, played a very prominent role in the law and in academia, but also, of course, primarily in, he's known to the party here as working very substantially within the SNP. A fine man who will be missed. Fine men both, actually, who will be missed.
Brian Taylor, thank you very much.